In this video, I'm going to show you how you can easily buy and sell shares on your smartphone using the CommSec mobile app. Let's get straight into it. Now firstly, please note that we are talking about the CommSec mobile app, not to be confused with the CommSec Pocket app, which is a totally different app run by the same company. I have made a separate video about CommSec Pocket app, which I'll link down below if you are interested. The CommSec mobile app is owned by Commonwealth Bank, which is Australia's largest bank. So it's no surprise that it is the number one online broker in Australia based on the number of users. Once you sign up for a CommSec account, you can either use the desktop version or the app version of the platform. I have previously done a video on the desktop version, but since I know most of you like to use your smartphone, today I'll show you how to use the app to buy and sell shares. And before we can do all that, I'll show you how to apply for a CommSec account and explain the brokerage fees and other useful features of the app. If you already know all these things and you're only interested to see how to buy and sell shares on the app, then feel free to skip ahead. I'll leave timestamps down below. But if you've never used CommSec before, then I suggest you watch the entire video so you don't miss anything important. And quick disclaimer, I'm not a financial advisor and this video is not financial advice. I'm just some random guy on the internet showing you how to use an online app. Please do your own research or consult a professional before investing your hard-earned money. Now, having said all that, I feel a lot of people get intimidated to even apply for a CommSec account. But I am here to tell you that it's very easy. In fact, I'll walk you through it right now. So to apply for an account, you'll need to go to the CommSec main page, then click Get Started, and it'll take you to this section, and just click Join Now. Then they will ask you a series of questions. Are you already a CommSec customer? Let's put no. If you're a CommBank customer, do you have a NetBank client number? I'll just put no for now, but if you are, then just put yes. How would you like to trade? With my own money or with a margin loan? Please select with my own money. If you're a beginner, I would recommend staying as far from margin as possible. Select which account you'd like to open. Now for most of you, it will either be individual or joint. If you have a partner and you would like to open a joint account, please note for tax purposes, you will pay 50% each for all your gains or dividends. So it's an even split. Okay, so a couple of things you need to know before you start. One, all applicants must be 18 or over and provide their personal details, Australian address, a valid email, a current mobile number, and tax residency information for Australian and overseas. This just means you have to declare if all your taxes are paid in Australia or do you pay taxes in other countries as well. And two, it's showing how the brokerage fees are charged. So you can find your CommSec account in two ways, and whichever method you choose will determine how much brokerage fees you will pay. The first option, which is the option I would strongly recommend, is to open a CDIA account, and this stands for Commonwealth Direct Investment Account. This is an account from Commonwealth which you can apply for and link to your CommSec trading account. It is free to sign up for, and it basically acts like a bank account to fund your trades. So if you use a CDIA account, these are the brokerage fees that you'll be charged. $10 for trade values up to and including $1,000, $19.95 for trades over $1,000 and up to $10,000, $29.95 for trades over $10,000 and up to $25,000, and a flat 0.12% for trades over $25,000. Now the other option to fund your CommSec account is to use another bank of your choice. If you do decide to do this, then you'll be charged a brokerage fee of $29.95 for all trades under $10,000. And a flat 0.31% for all trades from $10,000 and above. So clearly, you'll be paying way more brokerage fees if you go with another bank account. Again, I would strongly recommend opening a CDIA account since it's free anyway. So let's click continue. In the next page, you'll have to fill in some personal details. So things like your name, date of birth, residential address, and contact details, including your email and mobile number. Then they'll ask you about your job. Don't take this personally. By law, they have to ask this to everyone. So just pick a category that best suits your job type and select the type that best describes your job. So for me, I would pick professionals as the category and accountants for the type. Let's click next. And now they are asking you to choose your settlement account. So like I mentioned earlier, it's cheaper to just open a CDIA account to save on brokerage fees since it's free to open an account anyway. But if you still insist on using another bank account, then of course you can do that. Just be aware that you'll be charged a higher brokerage fee for your trades. For this tutorial, I'll just select the CDIA option and click Open CDIA. It will now ask you where you are a tax resident. I would recommend you read this part very carefully and make sure you select the right option as you don't want any problems with the ATO later on. But I'm guessing that most of you are Australian tax residents, so let's just select Australia. Then you have the option to enter your tax file number. If you choose not to, then by law, you may be charged the highest tax rate for any interest you may receive on your CDIA. So I would personally save myself the trouble and just enter it now. Then once you are done, let's click confirm. Now they are asking your permission to share your account details to your share registry so you can receive any dividends you are entitled to. So basically, a share registry is a third-party company that manages the admin work for shareholders. For example, if you buy some shares of Commonwealth Bank, a share registry will contact you on behalf of Commonwealth for any shareholder matters like where to pay your dividends, if you'd like to reinvest your dividends, or if you want to make a shareholder vote. If you're interested to know more, I have made a separate video about share registries and how to automatically reinvest your dividends. So I'll leave a link down below if you want to check it out. Let's now tick the box and click confirm. Now they will ask you to do a quick online ID check to make sure you are who you say you are. As long as you have your IDs on you, like your driver's license or your passport, then this should be very easy to complete. And once you pass this ID check, you'll be taken to a final page where you can review and submit your application. And it should take about 3 to 5 business days for them to approve your application. And congratulations, you are pretty much done. All right, now I'm gonna show you how to buy and sell shares on the CommSec app. Once your application has been approved, you can go to the App Store or Google Play, depending on what smartphone you have, and download the app. And there it is, it's this one here called CommSec Mobile. After you've already logged in once, you can set up Face ID so you don't have to manually enter your password every time. So now I'm gonna log into my account using Face ID, and there we are. Let's just ignore the other tabs on the bottom for now. I will come back to them later on and explain to you what they are. For now, let's click More. And there are 2 ways to buy shares. We can either click Get a Quote or click on Trade. Since this is your first time, let's click on Get a Quote. Now you can search for the company you want to invest in. So for this example, since we're using CommSec, let's say we want to buy some Commonwealth Bank shares. So you can either search for it by typing Commonwealth and it will come up with the right code. Or if you already know the company code, you can just search for CBA. And there it is on the first tab, let's select CBA. Now this page may look intimidating at first, but trust me guys, once you understand what everything is, you will find that it's not as complicated as it looks. I would encourage you to scroll around and familiarize yourself with everything on this page. So you have the depth chart here, which shows all the buyers and sellers and what they are currently bidding and offering. So you have course of sales, which shows all the trades that went through today for this stock. You have the yearly price chart, which you can filter to track the share price during any time frame you choose. You have stats like the 52 weeks highs and lows. You have the dividend offerings and dates. Then finally, you have all the important news and announcements from the company. And you even have some buy and sell recommendations from several investing companies. So once you've done your research and you've decided this is the company you want to buy, then let's scroll back up and click the green buy button. And from here, it's pretty simple. It's already got the company code chosen for you. Just double check that it is the right company that you want to buy. Then you can choose to buy in share quantity or by dollar value. So for example, let's keep it at quantity and enter 10. This means that you're asking the app to buy 10 shares of CBA. For the price, you can either enter the limit price or the market price. A limit price is the lowest amount that you are willing to pay per share of CBA. So if you scroll up a bit, you can see the last price was $103.32 per share. Then you can see the bid price of $103.15. And that number is the maximum amount someone is willing to pay per share. The offer price next to it is the lowest amount someone is willing to sell their shares. In this case, $103.15 is the lowest price someone is willing to sell you these shares. Just remember, when you are buying shares, there is always someone on the other side that you are buying from. And the same goes for selling your shares. You are always selling to another investor on the other side. So if you put the limit price as the current offer price, then it is highly likely that your buy order will go through instantly. If you think the share price will fall lower in the future, then you could always put a lower limit price. You can also select the market price, and that tells the app to buy the shares at the lowest market price at the time. I don't particularly like this option because sometimes the share price may fluctuate just as you're buying and you could end up paying more than you need to. If you want to buy at the lowest price, I would just set a limit price at the current offer price. That way, you are almost guaranteed to buy it at the exact price. So let's put the price limit amount to $103.15. Next, it will ask you for how long you want to keep this trade open for. If you select good till expiry and click order, you will see that your trade will expire in 20 days if your limit order does not trigger. If we go back and select good for day and press review order again, you will see that the expiry is today, which means if the trade does not go through today, then it will automatically expire by tomorrow. I usually prefer to use good for the day since I don't like waiting around for the trade to go through. Also, you may have noticed the brokerage is $19.95 since the total trade is over $1,000. So if you want to reduce the brokerage fee to $10, you can go back and change the quantity to 9. And if we click review order again, the brokerage fee is now $10 because the total order is under $1,000. You can also go back and change to purchase by value. So say you only have $1,000 to spend, the app will automatically select the number of shares that you can buy under $1,000. So in this case, you'll get 9 CBA shares. So you can play around with all the different combinations on this page. But if you're gonna do this, then please make sure you do this when the ASX is closed. The ASX opens from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time every day, except on weekends. So please make sure that you practice outside these hours and not when the market is open. You don't wanna be messing around and accidentally buying something by mistake. There is no cancel option if a trade has already gone through, and you will have to sell and waste brokerage fees if you wanna get your money back. So when you are absolutely 100% sure about your buy order, then come back to this review order page and click submit order. So it's about 7 p.m. where I am right now, so the market is closed. So in this instance, it has placed my order in a queue and it will be processed once the market opens tomorrow morning. If you submit the order when the market is open, then it will either go through instantly depending on your limit price, or it will join a queue until your limit price is filled. If your order does go through, you can check on manage order here and it will show you your order as executed in this area. CommSec will also email you a buy confirmation of your new shares. And that's it. Congratulations, you are now a shareholder of a company. Now, if the order has not gone through yet and you want to cancel this order, you can click Manage Order. Then click the order here and select Cancel Order and make sure the information is correct and click Cancel Order again. Then that should be it. But just to make sure, let's hit this More tab and click Orders. Here you should be able to see your cancelled order and make sure you have no current outstanding orders. If you can see that it's all clear, then you are good to go. So while we're on the More tab, remember how we used the Get a Quote option at the top to buy the CBA shares? If you are a more experienced investor and you already know exactly what you're buying, you can save some time and just click Trade. And this will bring you back to this familiar page and you can buy and sell whatever shares you want. So while we are here, I'm going to show you how to sell shares. And the example I'll use today to demonstrate is VAS, which is a popular ETF that I own. So let's select sell and enter the code. I'm going to type in VAS and now it's telling me that I have 262 shares of VAS in my CommSec account to sell. And the principle is similar as buying shares when it comes to the options below. I can either sell by quantity or by value. I find that it's much simpler to sell by quantity, so I'll just enter sell 10 shares. And for the limit price, I can put the current bid price, and this is the current highest price someone is willing to buy the shares from me. So I'll enter the current bid price of $88.02, and that will probably go through instantly. I could also put the market price, which will definitely make the trade go through instantly, but like I explained earlier, I don't want to risk any sudden market fluctuations. I could also set a higher limit price to say $90 per share, but it could be a while before the share price hits that target. So if I want to sell my shares quickly, then I'll just leave it at the current bid price of $88.02. Again, I can choose when the trade will expire. For now, I'll just select good for day. And in this section, it's asking for a settlement type. You don't have to worry too much about this one. Since CommSec is CHESS sponsored, meaning you own the shares directly, you should always select CHESS. Now let's select review order. Make sure you check that every line is correct. Then once you are happy, click submit order. And that's it. Your order will either process instantly or it will be added to a queue. And CommSec will also email you a sell confirmation letter. Now I want to talk about a unique feature about CommSec, and that is how they process the T+2 settlement. So T+2 settlement is a standard process that applies to all Aussie share market trades. When you buy or sell a share, there are two key dates. The T is the trade date when your order gets processed on the market. The +2 is the settlement date when you must pay your broker for ownership of the investment. So simply put, T+2 means the trade date plus 2 business days. So if you buy a stock on Monday, then you'll have to settle by Wednesday. Usually most Australian online brokers will require you to have the money already in your brokerage account before you can even buy the shares. However, CommSec allows you to buy the shares even if your account balance is zero. But then you'll have to put the amount owing in your CDIA account by settlement date. So I would strongly recommend before buying any shares at all to have the exact amount already sitting in your CDIA account so you don't forget to transfer the money or your money somehow gets stuck in transit for some reason. Let's now talk about the other tabs and features on the app. So the first tab is your portfolio. This is where all the stocks you own will be grouped neatly together for you. And my apologies for blurring out my screen for obvious reasons. I just don't want you guys to see my investments and try to copy them. Please remember that every person has their own risk tolerance, so you'll need to do your own research and decide which companies are suitable for you. And FYI, if you have a CommSec Pocket account like me, then you'll have it grouped in a separate portfolio on top of your regular CommSec account. And that is the reason why my name appears twice on the screen. And on the bottom here, it will show you your CDIA account and your current balance. Let's now move on to the Watch tab, and in this area, you can create watch lists of certain stocks and companies that you want to keep track of. So for example, you may want to track the performance of the Big Four banks. So you can create a new watch list, give it a name, and manually add each stock like so. Or maybe you want to track all the popular ETFs in Australia. So here's one that I've already created. So you can create as many watch lists as you want and you can have it ready for you to monitor. Let's now move on to newsfeed. On this page, you get little snippets of information on companies that you own or have looked up in the past. So it's a little bit like your Facebook feed where the algorithm will show you news that they think you want to see. So it's mainly a lot of technical analysis and market announcements. You can also click the icon on the top right and filter what type of news you want to see. So say you're only interested in recommendation changes. You can just select that and your feed will just be investing companies giving you their recommendations. Let's now move on to the markets tab. This page provides a high level summary of what has happened in the day for the stock market in Australia and the rest of the world. So you can play around with these charts here for international, Asia Pacific and Australia. Then you have a bunch of popular indices from all across the world, like the S&P 500, which represents the top 500 US companies listed on multiple US stock exchanges. You have the FTSE 100, which represents the top 100 UK companies listed on the London Stock Exchange. You also have the Nikkei 225, which represents the top 225 Japanese companies listed on the Tokyo Stock Exchange. And you can Google the rest of these, but it's nice to see how the global stock market is doing in general. Then you have the market movers broken down in large cap, mid cap, and small caps. Then you also have your commodities like gold, silver, and other precious metals. Then you have a list of these currency pairs and how they are performing against each other. So again, I would recommend you take some time to have a look around this page if you are interested in the daily fluctuations of the stock market and the global economy. One last feature I want to show you is how to set up alerts. So this feature allows you to set an alert if something significant changes about a stock you are interested in. So let's click on the More tab and select Alert. Say you are interested to buy CBA shares, but you don't want to pay $100 per share. You can then set a trigger price for $90, so if the price falls below that amount, CompSec can send you a push notification on your phone or an email. You can also set an alert for volume changes, but that is more useful for day traders, so it's probably not applicable to you at this very moment. And lastly, you can also set an alert for whenever CBA sends out a market-sensitive announcement or when they are about to pay a dividend. So once you have selected your criteria, you can click Create and it will create an alert for you. Easy peasy. And this should be it in terms of all the relevant features, but if you have any questions about anything, then please let me know down below in the comments and I'll do my best to reply to you all. And by the way, if this video was helpful for you and you made it this far, please comment yellow down below so I know that you are one of my true OGs. Also, consider subscribing to my channel if you haven't already, because I'll be making more future videos like this and you don't want to miss them. So now you know how to use CompSec. But if you're still confused on what to do next, then check out this video on screen where I talk about some of Australia's most popular ETFs. Here, I'll break down each ETF and what they offer to their investors. So I think this could be useful for you. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you and I'll see you in the next video.